Welcome back to Apollo Justice Ace Attorney. I could interview you right this way. Who said that? Hey, it's Trucy. Oh yeah, you found the right place. Welcome. What's this girl? Shout again. Be in what? The interview. First things first. Any special talents? Talents? Well, you must have at least one. I guess defending? That doesn't count as a talent. It sounds like it'll do. A little jazzing up, of course. You think so? Let's give it a go, shall we? Go ahead, show me you defend. I got something like that. I can't defend here. It's even in a courtroom. But listen, a professional can perform anywhere. Thanks, I guess. I want people to be laughing at us. Not at us. Thanks, again. But I'm not sure why they should be laughing at us at all. What? What sort of do you think you came here to do? Defend as an attorney, no? Excuse me? Do you know where you are? The right anything offices? Or maybe that was what it was formerly known as. Afraid of that. Don't worry, you're not the first to mistake. What's going on here? Who are you exactly? Hit me with the person in charge. Yeah, you're talking to her. You apparently made no fewer than two mistakes. One, mistakes such as, but I got called from Mr. Wright this morning. Perhaps you should go read the sign on the front again. Instead of relook, it says right here. Now he gets it. Yeah, it's not on the right anything offices. Right. Talent agency? Talent agency, yeah. Man, I'm gonna say the right talent agency. You've always come to the right place. Trissy Wright, CEO on the magician. I called it. I didn't know she was a CEO. I came flinging back. The trial. That girl. Flashback. She aimed the card. Pick a card. One of the blade. On the singer on the pendant. She's my daughter. I think it's right. Trissy Wright? Turn the flyer. Oh, it's for magic. So, what's your name? Apollo Justice, attorney at law. So we have to talk. Right, talent agency? This is really a talent agency. You bet. Daddy started 7 years ago when he quit law. Ah, ouch. Of course, we only had two people sign up right away. Right now. Two people, does that include you? Trissy Wright, magician extraordinaire. I've done a lot of stage shows, paid too. Professionally, you know. Right. Promise to come to one of my shows, okay? Let's see. Oh, and the other person I can see references. Phoenix Wright, pianist extraordinaire. The same Phoenix did that, in other words. Yeah. Didn't you say he couldn't play the piano? Doesn't see that as a problem anymore. Well, there are magicians who can't do magic. Many magicians can't do magic. At least you're optimistic, I'll give you that. Trissy Wright. So you're his daughter, Phoenix Wright's adoptive daughter, to be precise. Right. After Daddy quit law 7 years ago, I promised I would keep him fed. So I kind of assure Daddy, yeah. That doesn't make any sense, Jager. No. I'm in charge of this whole office too. That I get. Pretty amazing for a young lady. Lasted 15 years old, wouldn't you agree? 15? Wow, she's young. How old is Phoenix right now? That's a secret. He's 33 years old. This every 30 years. 32 years old, wow. Good explanation, I hope. Anyway, moving on. Phoenix Wright. How about Mr. Wright giving up law? It was because of that incident 10 years ago, wasn't it? You know about that? Not exactly the details, but I remember the news, it was a big deal. So I heard. I still don't understand what was going on. I'll tell you about it the next time I get a chance. Daddy Wright. Not only you, but Mr. Phoenix Wright. He gave me a call this morning to come in. Not here right now. He's in the hospital. Oh. Hospital. He's on strict bed rest until he gets better. He's sick? Wait, I didn't know about that. Hospital, Mr. Wright, and I'll pay him a visit. No, no, no. He's in the... Hayfield Clinic is quite close. Alright, I'll be going now, and I'll give this service and give some thought, okay? Wait, I'll go with you. Very well, she'll show him the way. June 15, 9:45 a.m. Hayfield Clinic. Mr. Wright's hospital. Wow. Who's this guy? The doctor, I assume. Visitors, are you? Yeah, are you the doctor? Yeah, Dr. Hickfield's name. Yeah, some gold front of teeth, I think. I'm missing a few. Good morning, Doc. Hi, there, Trissy. Cheers, Everett. Is this guy's room? Hope he's gone for the morning checkup. Be right back soon. Hi, Miss Trissy. Got any places I examined? Down pressure luck, buddy. The nurse is looking for you. Hey, there's Phoenix. And isn't the guy the cutest technical thing in the town? How old is this guy anyway? I'll be off then. Later, Trissy. That guy's a creep. An odd bird that guy was. Good morning. Didn't expect you so soon of all. Hey, Mr. Wright. What's that they happened? So, what happened? Who could have imagined it? Me, victim of a hit and run.
Hit and run? Wow.
You were hit by a car? I tried to swerve, I give him that. Pushed me a telephone 30 feet to the air. When I stopped me, my head hit the telephone pole.
Ow.
Hit the telephone pole with your head? Are you okay? Thankfully, my only injury was a sprained ankle. He always looks like, as they say. How about Trissy? Something that, well, it just doesn't seem straight. You have a daughter, right?
Adoptive daughter.
She's so big, not bad, but, what are you,
popular-wise?
Trissy's still a child, to be safe. I just have to remind you, I'm not a child anymore. What do you want to be daddy to look over me, Trissy? I'm not, my foot, I'm not fine yet. So, something you should know about Trissy. She's a magician, right? So no, not that. She's a doctor. She's a genius. Oh, God. Daddy. We'll soon come to appreciate her talent. You just tell me things instead of seeing them. And right time, see. Why'd you contact me? For the right time, see, possibly with me. I need to get pretty now. And not to be driving into like this. But didn't you come into balance of your own free will anyway? But that was a defense attorney office. I'm patrolling the office here. Big. Thought someone was dying. So you don't think this is a big trouble? The time is represents only two people, and one of them is in the hospital. That's right, Daddy. How am I going to pay this month's rent and the groceries? Fair point. That's the problem with such a tight operation. That's a symbolic bit. Bad relationship. Which one of us falls, the other does too. Two must fall. Seems like a suitable conversation we're to be having with a 15-year-old.
Shh, don't call her a kid.
Right. Apollo here can't help you. I have to transfer to a new school again.
Again?
And this happened before? I can't. I just made new friends. And just me. Don't ask Polly. What? Now it's my fault. Remember, how about you come work for us? The perfect client for you already lined up. Another client? Do my job still? Yes, of course. What else we would do? Alright. I'll hear what you have to say. Yeah, I'm done. I'm fine with thinking. Now it's time to reel him in.
What?
It's official. I'm scared. You better be. Our client. So who's this client? Here, take a look at the map and I'll explain. Map. Right over. I thought I left the office before 9 o'clock and Sid's two places marked on the map.
Mr. Wright is in red, going to that Indonesian Indochini pasta joint. Aldean ties. Pipiano there, of course. That's when it happened. Car came out of nowhere. Just me flying. Nick the telephone pole. And zoomed away. Creepy, huh? It's a tad. Almost as creepy as hearing tell a story of another dude. Be right back.